The topic, brothers, sisters, about the companions, we spoke about this. This is not the first khutbah. This is not the first khutbah because, as I mentioned, the khutbah, when we speak about the companions, it means we are speaking about our religion. Without the companions, the Quran will not come to us. Will not come to us, the Quran. Because who took the Quran from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam? The companions. Who taught this Quran to the Tabi'een, the next generation, the companions, radiyallahu ta'ala. Who understood the Quran and the Sunnah at the best way? The companions, radiyallahu ta'ala. Tayyib. Sheikh, do you mean that the companions are angels? The companions are sinless? They don't do any mistake? They don't do anything wrong? No, we don't mean this. We don't mean this. Companions are, radiyallahu ta'ala, are human beings. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose them to convey the message from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the world. And their ijma' is mistakenless. Definitely right, their ijma', if they have consensus, ijma'. Tayyib. But as a single companion, yes, you can find different issues in fiqh. Maybe Ibn Abbas will give fatwa different than Ibn Mas'ud or Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, different than Umar radiallahu anhu. You can find this in fiqh, in the salah, in the hajj. Okay, but as a whole religion, the companions radiallahu ta'ala anhum, we have to respect, we have to love. Why I'm saying this? Because maybe sometimes people are interested to know what are the mistakes of the companions. What happened among them. And this is totally wrong. Why? Because number one, you have to study your religion. How to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala properly according to the sunnah. How to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many times people are ignorant in their deen. They don't care about their, they are not observing the five prayers in the masjid. And they like to know what happened. Why this companion said this to this companion, they have this fighting, they have this disagreement. This is not our issue. And the scholar's mission, it is not allowed to go and search about their mistakes. Radiallahu ta'ala anhum. And Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah rahimahullah mentioned what you find, okay, number one, most of that not authentic. Most of that is not authentic. About the companions of the Allah Ta'ala. Please brothers, be careful. If you listen to a da'iyah, very famous, well-known da'iyah, doesn't mean he's right. Wallahi, there are many deviant da'iyah. Even if they have millions of followers, they are misguiding you. Wallahi, be careful. Sometimes we give our brain to this da'iyah. Yallah, do whatever with our brain. You lead us, you guide us. Why? You should think. You should think. Please think about this. Think about what this sheikh is saying, what this da'i is saying. Don't give your heart and your brain, yourself to this da'iyah. You give your heart, your brain to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the religion. Khalas, you follow. If you like, you say, you follow blindly the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because definitely he is religion, he is wahi, revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As he said subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, وَيُسَلِّمُ تَسْلِيمًا, you give full submission for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It means for the religion. But for any sheikh, no, Allah, he's speaking very well. His language, his way, smiling. Okay, this doesn't mean he's right. It doesn't mean this, he's right. What is the point of that? Brothers, the job of the scholars is to teach religion. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَكِنْ كُونُوا رَبَّانِيِّينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you should be Rabbani. What's in the Rabbani? Okay, one of the meanings of Rabbani, the scholars mention, الْعُلَمَاءَ الَّذِينَ يُعَلِّمُونَ النَّاسِ صِغَارَ الْعِلْمِ قَبْلَ كِبَارِهِ. The scholars who are teaching people the basics for people. They are teaching people basics before the complicated or difficult issues. For example, I have a class, new Muslims, all the brothers, doctors, engineers, cleaners, all kinds of jobs. So do you think this is a good idea? Yalla, come and I teach you how to calculate the zakah of the banks and shares? Is it a wisdom to teach them? I do a course how to teach. This is not wisdom. This is not the way of Rabbanin. I should teach you how to apply, yani how to perform the wudu according to the sunnah. How to fast like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How to perform the salah. What is the point now, people coming to the masjid, all new Muslims, okay, and I am teaching them what happened between this companion and the other companion. What is the point of that? And they don't know how to pray. So the companions, radiallahu ta'ala, are part of our religion. And we have to follow their way. We have. This is not an option. Allah mentioned this in the Quran. وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقَ الرَّسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعَ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقَ الرَّسُولِ. The one who is going apart from the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in one way and he is in another way. يُشَاقِق وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقَ الرَّسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى. After the huda, after the guidance became clear for him, then he said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And he is following other than the way of the believers. So it is important to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam according to the way of the companions radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this ayah in Surah Nisa, وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. What is the meaning سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ? The way of the believers. When Allah revealed the Quran, who are meant by this ayah? Companions, radiallahu ta'ala anhum. So we have to follow the way of the companions. You have to check what was the way of the companions. Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ammar, Abu Huraira. You have to follow that. No, but now we are 2022, we should change. Wallahi, some da'iyah like this. Okay? No, I was there, but now I change. More research. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. It is not a mobile. Wallahi, I'm looking for the latest mobile. With artificial intelligence or habibi, the religion, you should follow the old. Alaykum bil amr al awwal, follow al amr al awwal, the first thing. In religion, no, we want something the old. Why? Because if you go back, it means you are closer to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And if you try to search now, it means you are far from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So for our religion, no, we want to be old, go back. Not 100 years, 200, go back 1,400 years. To the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the companions. This is the best and the safest way. This man is speaking, well, this man, don't listen to him. He's shaitan, wallahi he's shaitan. The one who's accusing the companions, or he's trying to tell you, well, I know this is knowledge, it is written in the books, Ibn Kathir, al-Dahabi. What is the point? Okay, Ta'al, what is the point? Please, brothers, think. What is the point when I speak about the companions badly? Or to tell you what happened? Yes, I mention what is in the book. What will happen? You will hate this companion. Wallahi, you will hate this companion, and you will love this companion, and you hate the other, the third. Definitely. Definitely. If I tell you about any war between Kuwait, between Iraq, between India, between Pakistan, any war, if I explain, subhanAllah, as a human nature, you will love one country and you will hate the other, صح? As a human nature. So definitely you will love this companion, you will hate the other one. And this is misguidance. This is misguidance. As Muslims, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. We should love all the believers. We should love all the Muslims. We should do the things, we should read the things which bring the love in the Muslim ummah. Because if you spread the love, if you have the love, you will enter paradise. لَنْ تَدْخُلْ جَنَّةَ حَتَّى تُؤْمِنُوا وَلَنْ تُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى تَحَابُوا أَوَلَا دُرُّكُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ إِذَا فَعَلْتُمْ تَحَبَبْتُمْ أَفْشُوا السَّلَامَ بَيْنَكُمْ. You will not enter paradise until you believe. You will not believe until you love. Do you like that I tell you something? If you do, you love each other, spread peace. Give salam. Afshu salam baynakum. So, our religion as simple as that. The companions are those who convey the message to us. We have to love them and we have to follow their way. They are human beings? Yes. No doubt, they are human beings. They are not angels. They are not messengers. Okay, and also we should not exceed the limit in their love. As we mentioned in the khutbah, we should not worship them. It is haram to worship the companions. We don't give anything special for their graves. Okay, and for example, when you go to Medina, some people believe there is something special in Baqi' because the companions are there. Nothing special. They are dead people. Khalas, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. But what is special? Their way. To follow their way. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to love them and to follow them. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi.